This is still an investigational tool. It is been at least our investigational retinal amyloid imaging, where we use curcumin or just fluorescent signature to look at amyloid beta plaque in the retina of patients. This is being tested and validated in multiple places around the world, across the US, in Europe, in the UK, in France, across a large study, ABLE study in Australia. So this needs to be validated. Also in our Cedars-Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles, we are doing analysis, and we just published last year an analysis of these retinal amyloid plaque increased in mild cognitive impaired patients, and their burden in the retina predicted atrophy in the hippocampus of these patients. We could also stratify the patients based on their cognitive score, looking just at retinal amyloid imaging. So we're looking at several techniques. None of them are FDA approved. Our technique is in the process of being approved, but it needs validation and large patient samples. Right now, what we are using is a scanning laser or modified laser scanning ophthalmoscope to look at the patient. And this takes about, 15 minutes. Around 15 minutes. And then there is a process of post image processing and analysis, digitalizing the data and having numbers and burden of, amyloid, what we call retinal amyloid index. Other teams have most notably, there is the optical coherence tomography that looks at either optical OCT angiography that looks at blood vessels, or OCT that looks at the structure of the retina and defines layers of the retina to look at atrophy. So these are modalities that are very, very important to look at the structure of the retina and whether there are major structural changes, but not that specific to amyloid beta or tau, which are the defining signs of Alzheimer's disease. So these differences or changes in OCT could be also found in other ocular diseases or neurological diseases. Another important, I think, advance is hyperspectral imaging. And this is basically looking at spectral signature of different biological structures. And people apply this tool to do retinal imaging. And there is a group in Minnesota and in Australia that has described those specific changes in hyperspectral imaging as correlating to amyloid in the brain, amyloid burden in the brain. So, and there are many indications that actually hyperspectral imaging can define amyloid beta plaque also in the retina. So this is also an exciting, avenue for patients. But all of them are investigational still, and they are developed and tested and validated in many, many teams around the world.